Okay, today we're going to have a very special class. This class usually we do not share, but because we people ask, I'm going to start explaining. I hope everybody will understand this format. Okay, so we starting with the Ktoret. The Zohar Kadosh says that a person understands the Ktoret and does it the right way, he can stop death from the world, wake up sick people from their sickness. But that's only Zohar says, if you know, the Kavana of the Ktoret. So since we're recording for other people to see also, we cannot do it only in Russian. We have to do it. But that's also good. That's also a good point. But right now we want to do it in English for the English speakers as well. Okay, so we try to put the camera in a way that everybody will see what we're doing. Okay, Ata. So says the Arizal HaKadosh says, before you start the Torah, you have to start with Vaydaber Adonai El Moshe Lemor, Kach Lecha Samim, Nataf Shchelet Echelbena Samim Ulvona Zakai, Takdali. And you finish in Reach Necho Achi Shel Amonai, write God's name. And then you say Ata. You do not start Torah with Ata. You're supposed to make preparation for that before that. So the Kavanot here starts with Ata, so that's why you started with Ata. But before that, you're supposed to already read Kach Lecha Samim, Nataf Shchelet Echelbena, all this words before. If you have the sidur, we have the sidur, bring us a regular sidur.
But all the in the mincha, all the ktoret, if you're opening, is starting from Ata.
The klav ktoret that you mean.
The klav
starts from Ata. But the actual ktoret is supposed to start.
Even if you're going to Google and putting a ktoret, the ktoret is starting from Ata.
Right, so the Arizal says, do not start from Ata. Make sure you start from Vaydaber, whatever. This is the text we're going to say. ודבר אדוני אל משה לאמור צו את בני ישראל ואמרת עליהם קורבני לחמי לישי all these texts
שחרית
כתובנה יבד בי שחרית all the way ריח ניחו אחי אישה ריח ניחו אחלה אדוני then אתה הוא. Okay, in this sidur the Kavanot level is very very limited. In this sidur that everybody you know called the Kabbalistic sidur is very limited. Okay, so now you should know in Ktoret the concept of the word Ktoret is to tie down. Ktoret means to tie. In Hebrew, likshor means to tie. In Aramaic is liktor. That's a ktoret called ktoret because you're tying something over here. Mm. And there's a lot of things they're going to tie. There's a lot of system we have to tie in order for the kedusha to get strong in this world and the tumah to become weaker in this world. So it says over here like this. Ata, you have to right now correspond to sfira of, partzuf of Abba. If you remember on Shabbat, we spoke about what's the difference between Partsuf and Sfira. We said Sfira is individual of one, is one out of ten, Sfira. And Partsuf is within it, there is ten Sfirot. Partsuf is a group of Sfirot. Got it? So it says over here like this, Ata, who, so it says the first word, Ata, corresponding to Sfira, to Partsuf, of Abba. Abba is another nickname to the word Sfirat Chokhmah. When you just look at Chokhmah out of the 10, it's called Sfirat Chokhmah. But whenever you're looking at the 10 Sfirot of Chokhmah, Chokhmah becomes a group of 10 Sfirot. How do you call this? Abba. Partsuf of Abba. That's
all 10 Sfirot?
All 10 Sfirot. If you look at Chokhmah, if you zoom in, you know today in the video, we have zoom in, right? If you zoom in into Chokhmah, you'll have 10 Sfirot in it also.
Only in Chokhmah?
No, any of the Sfirot. Any of the Sfirot. Zooming into a Sfira and seeing over there another 10 Sfirot qualifies the whole 10 Sfirot as one group. And this one group called Partsuf. Got it? We have Partsuf of Abba corresponding to Sfirat Chokhmah. When you look at the picture of 10, is located where Chokhmah is. Then you have Atahu, says over here, Ima. So right at the beginning, you're making connection, you are tying down. That's Ktoret, right?
Ata
to tie down.
Abba, who is Ima?
Right. It's written here for you. Ata is Abba, and who is Ima. And you see right away what happens? Ihud, Abba, Ima. You see Aleph, Vav, Aleph? Aleph, Vav, Aleph stands for Abba, Ima. Right away, you're connecting between Partsuf of Abba. You have to have in mind, I'm connecting right now. Ata, Partsuf of Abba. Who? Partsuf of Ima. I'm connecting them together. Whenever Abba and Ima, father and mother, get connected, what happens? comes down, child to the world. What is child? Bracha to the world, right? The Bukhari used to say, Chanta Barachodori. Always used to say, what does it mean? Because children are your bracha in the world. Okay, Atahu Adonai Eloheinu. Now, Atahu, you connected Abba and Ima Bemesti. The Patsuf of Abba and Ima together. Hashem Elokeinu, you're connecting Za-I-Nuk. Which is, in another words, you have Yud-Ke, then you have Vav-Ke. Yud is Chokhmah. He is Bina.
Zayin.
Yud et a Papa, He et a Mama. Right? That's in Hebrew, Bechor. Man is called Ish. Aleph Yud, Shin. Isha is called Yud, Aleph, Shin, He. What's the difference between the Ish and the Isha? Here is Yud, there is He. Ask any Israeli, why Ish has Yud, Isha has He? Nemedonam. The answer will be, I don't know. If you ask them Kubalim, why man has Yud, Aisha has He? The answer would be, man is the giver, which is corresponding to first God's name, which is the Yud. Yud gives to the woman.
Isha has Yud also.
Isha is, no, Aleph Shin, He. That's the proper grammar of to write. The Israelis that have a hard time to read without, you can read as different way and then Isha, or you could read Ishe or something like that, then they write Yud also, so people will know it's Chirik. But in Torah, Isha is called, is written, Aleph Shin Hei, not Aleph Yud Shin Hei. Where is it written with Yud? When you want to refer to her her husband. Ve Isha, with the dot in the Hei, and the Yud and the Aleph. Ve Isha Yeferenu, right? The Torah talks about that. So he says, Atahu, there's four words over here. Atahu, Adonai Eloheinu. Atahu, you're connecting Yud and Hei, which is Abba and Ima. Adonai Eloheinu, you're connecting another level of giver. Hashem is the giver, which is Vav and Hei, together. And if you see over here, it says, Ihud Zun. Combination of Zun stands for Za, which is the last six firot, Chesed all the way to Yesod, and N. And what is N? Nukva. Nukva is the Malchut, is the receiver. The ultimate receiver is the Nukva. In Sefirot, it's called Malchut.
So, Hashem is Abba Ima.
No. Ata, who is Abba Ima?
Abba.
Ata, Abba.
So, Mazel,
who? Now, when you say the word Ata, who, you have to have in mind, I'm combining Abba together with Ima. Parsuf Abba together with Parsuf of Ima. Which is called Ihud Abba Ve Ima. Then when you said the other words, which is the third and the fourth word, Hashem Elokeinu, now you're combining Za Inuk, which is Vav and Hey of God's name. Is this clear?
Okay, so when you're starting Atahu,
in Patsufi,
so you
Atahu, you have in mind Abba and Ima. I'm combining the two.
Abba Ima together, and
which is Yud and Hey, which is Yud and Hey.
Yeah.
Now the Bracha of Yud and Hey should not supposed to stay in the Shamayim. It's supposed to count down to here. So the word Ktoret in Hebrew is from the word Likshor. In Aramaic, Liktor, in Hebrew is Likshor. Zavizat. You right now making Zavizavizavish. You're combining together.
So it's not Lechaber, Likshor, Ela Likshor.
Right, exactly. You are combining together, tying together. Vish, he tells you here, Chagai, look further. Sheiktiru Kashru. What is kashu in Hebrew? That they tie down. Atahu Adonai Eloheinu shiktiru.
Lechaber is you tying down that.
Now what do you call what? Look at the further words. Shiktiru avotenu. How many avotenu we had before? Abba. Sorry.
Abraham.
Yitzhak, Yaakov, which is Chesed. Gevura Tiferet. They're supposed to be right now combined to be tied down with the bracha of Chesed together with Gevura, together with Tiferet, supposed to be tied down together.
Don't we say that Moshe Rabbeinu, he received that Pitom Haktoret to not have
Moshe Rabbeinu, Malach HaMavet gave that secret. Every Malach gave a gift to Moshe Rabbeinu when he was in Shamayim. Every Malach. Not only Malach HaMavet, every Malach.
But
the Malach HaMavet gave, they said, this is the power, the antidote against me. Wow. And Rabotai, that's another joke. in Eretz Israel, whenever there is big problems happen, they take them kubalim, reading the Pitum Aktorit in the city, they're reading the Pitum Aktorit in hospitals, people become healthy. This is not a joke. It's a very strong segula. Rabbi Kaduri, whenever Iran, I don't remember how many years ago, it was 20 years ago, attacked Israel, he told everybody, he printed these pamphlets, he told everybody read this. Panimaish, read this. Rabbi Kaduri. I still have a pamphlet that used to, in my home. Clean, takoy, maybe 30 pages. Pamphlet. Rabbi Kaduri, he called it, Magen, Chota Magen, Khalifat Magen, Chotakoi, the protection of your house.
So they knew that already before Avraham and Yitzchak Yaakov, they knew that they tied it.
So remember, Avraham Yitzchak Yaakov, representative of Sfirot. Avraham did in this world the most amount of Chesed. That's why he stands for Chesed. Yitzchak stands the most amount for Gevura. And Yaakov stands for Tiferet. You got it? They are representative of those powers in this world. Understand? Okay, Shiktu Avotenu. Avotenu, skoka Avotenu we had? Three. That's why you see Chagat. Chot Chagat? Chet is Chesed. Gimel is Gevura. Taf is Tiferet. You see, you can read this another 30, 40 years. You're not going to understand any of the secrets behind it. Surat Bori Mebi, Partet Bori Rav Meri.
Avotenu is a Chagat?
Chagat.
Lefanecha. Et ketor et asami.
Avotenu is Chagat, you said, but this Tiferet. Chesed Gevura
Tiferet.
Tiferet. So this is Chagat.
Right. Chesed Gevura Tiferet. Ektirut. He tells you. Kashru. Tie down.
Tie down.
Okay. No. I didn't know you guys are gonna be interested in this. Lefanecha. Et Hamalchut. Yeah, you have the words there.
The words are there.
Et says right now you're tying all the Sfirot, pay attention to all the Patsufim. Ata, Abba, Hu, Ima, Hashem, Za, all Chesed till the Yesod. Right?
Elokenu.
Elokenu, Nuk, which is the Malchut. Now, what are you doing? You're tying this, it says, Kashu Avotenu, which is Chesed Gevura Tiferet. They tie the Bracha of Chesed Gevura Tiferet together with Malchut.
That's the process.
What is it? Malchut. Why? Aleph till Taf. All the Bracha from Aleph till Taf funnels down to Malchut.
That's the second Malchut you're having in the same sentence.
Not to say second Malchut.
Because Elokeinu also is Malchut.
The Nuk, you're right. The in Partsuf. If you look in Partsuf, it's Partsuf. You are correct. Here you're talking about Sfira. Okay? Ketoret.
Paul Orasham says Za Venuk.
He wrote here. Yehud Za Inuk. Those are terminologies we were teaching you on Shabbat. That's why it's important to participate in this Shabbat lectures that I always tell you. Mata. Yeah. Et ketoret, slova ketoret, how do you spell down in Hebrew? Kuf tet vav resh taf, isn't that right? Make mathematics. I told you there's going to be a lot of mathematics today.
Gimatri,
yeah. Kuf is 100. Tet is 9. Vav, 6 resh. 200 taf. 400. So we have 600.
715.
7, very good. And 9 and 715, very good. Slova Ketoret, Gimatri Vobujit, 715. Right? Why is it called Ketoret 715? It says because you should know when God created the world, there was a breakage of the Kelim. It's called Shvirat HaKelim. Mm-hmm. All the Sfirot wanted the Bracha to be only to themselves. They didn't want to share. Right. When a person gets from God Bracha and he doesn't want to share, his Bracha breaks. Nivajak Totebujish. It was this highest level Sfirot. Highest level. They took God's bracha only to themselves. God said only to yourself. All the light of God broke their killing. All the bracha they were supposed to have. Imagine a person has a certain box that he puts money over there. Gold, jewelry, whatever it is. One day that box breaks and everything spills and everybody just takes and steals it from him. What was the point he took all this money and all this, saved all this? Nothing. He lost everything. Nachon? Lo aleinu, lo aleichem. Says that's the same thing when a person takes God's bracha. Chudam churam, chudam muram amchel. That's what happens. Chudam mechuri, no problem. Chudam memuri. It's going to break. It's going to break.
Yeah,
you're right. So now, it says, so now, say, listen to this. Whenever it broke, the deen started in the world. God's light became judgment now. If things break. When you break things, when you're happy and when you're upset, whenever you're judgmental right now. Whenever it's judgmental. So it says, our job from this judgment that 10 sefirot or makif ichni, how much is going to be together? 10 sefirot and or makif together? 11. How many samamanim do we have? 11 samamanim ayuba. Every one of them has God's name of judgment. God's name of judgment, which it is? Amonai. Right? So it says, Ado and Denai, Gimatra 65. Zele 65, multiply 65 times 11. There's 11, right? How much is going to come out? Make mathematics.
666.
No, not
65 times 11.
65 times 11.
750.
Very good. Kol hakavod. What did we get? Ketoret. What Ketoret does? Remove the judgment from all the sefirot that they were locked with the judgment. Yeah? Gimatria Yud Aleph Pe'amim Amonai. 11 Pe'amim. You see, Amonai, 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 Amonai. 11. I don't say God's name, but you're supposed to, you're supposed to have in mind. No, no. Aleph Dalet. Anivrarim HaKlipot. The one that they are, get removed from the Klipot. Yaakov, you're not looking inside. You mind switching the seat with Nisan and he's going to share with him? Or Nisan, или Nisan, или Okalam Yasidi. Идем, чтобы ты увидел. I see that you're interested to look inside, so you should look inside.
I'm looking at his, but...
No, там is. Потом будет время тратить. Let's go.
Давай, so this...
You know, Kafachaim, Bechor Kafachaim says that a person doesn't learn Kabbalah, he comes back, he says, as a geese. You hear this or no? Person that doesn't learn Kabbalah, he's going to come back Ilgul as a geese. Geese in English it's called. Geese. White geese. It's written, Arizal writes it. That's, it's very important for you, not just to know Parasha, Moshe, Posharo, Moshe, Alachot. You have to grow to Kabbalah also.
Rabbi, this name, the Shem Hashem,
this is God's name of judgment. You see, in the name, Ado and Enai, you have the word Master of Din. Dalet Yud Nun, book of Paminyai, Slova Zamesad Nai, Bujit, Din. What is Din in Hebrew?
Judgment.
That's why God's name of judgment is Ado Nai. Choita, I am the master of Din. What is Din?
Din. Din.
Din,
da. Got it? No, don't joke around.
Why is only half a name over here? 1, 2, 3.
No, half a name. Why half a name? Ado and then Nai. Paul Nehemiah. אוקיי, אני שמים בזמן שבית המקדש קיים, כאשר ציפית אותם על יד משה נביא, כך כתוב בתורתך, נא רבותיי. This is what we're reading. קטורת. Yeah, there's no covenant already.
פתאום הקטורת.
נא רבותיי, at the beginning, reading קטורת with covenant is going to take you forever. It's going to take you maybe half an hour, maybe even more. If you're reading with covenant, understand everything you do. As time goes by, you'll do it much, much quicker. Much quicker. ויאמר אדוני אל משה. On Friday, בעזרת השם, is going to be ברית.
What time?
I don't know what time, but they're going to have a ברית. Today I went to check the baby. ברית?
Are you going to do that?
Yeah, I'm going to, בעזרת השם, כאן.
You going to do that?
ולא שמחות? Yeah, בעזרת השם. I went to check the baby today on Friday. It's very important during the... Etat, breed to read the Ktoret. I'm not sure where it does. I think that is. Yeah, very important. Why Sandak gives Zechut to be wealthy? Do you know? Because they say whenever Sandak sits down, Bechor, I will not repeat it. When Sandak sits down and he's taking the baby. By the way, Sandak's supposed to take the baby. They're not supposed to give him the baby. He's supposed to take the baby. Give me the baby, yeah. Usually it sits like this, they give it to him. It's a mistake. It's supposed to be taking the baby. I'm not going to say things. You know, people get upset. I'm telling you what's written.
Down,
what's written is they're supposed to take the baby when you sandak. Why is sandak's gula to be wealthy? Because the poskim say it looks like a person that brought ktoret now.
Wow.
That sacrifice of that brit milah is as you brought ktoret. So what's the most important thing to read during the brit? Ktoret. That's the most belong things.
It's going to be after Nets.
I'm not sure the timing. He didn't tell me.
8 o'clock is going
to
be there.
It could be from Sidur or it has to be from the Klav.
Anything. Best with Sidur, Klav, best. But if you cannot, do Sidur. Vayomer Adonai el Moshe. Now, when you said the word Moshe, Yechaven ki Moshe otiyot. You see, God's Moshe flipped the letters around. What word did you get? That's name. Do not mention this name. Yechaven. Only have Kavana. It's not Hashem. It's Mem. And then... Видишь, это не Ашем, это другое имя. Веу эхад меайн бечемо.
Зе атаху Ашем Элокену Ицаху.
I didn't look. What is that name? So this is one of the 72 names. Whenever God split the sea, he used 72 names to do that. One of those names, we say in Lulav, Ani, Vahu, Hoshi, Ana. What is Ani? One of the 72 names, three letters. Ani, Aleph, Dalet, Nud. Aleph, Nun, Yud. Ani. Vahu, Vav, Hey, Vav. It's one of the 72 names. And this is, says the Arizal, is also one of the 72 names. And what is that name? It says, why Ktoret? You are interrupting. I'm sorry. Excuse me. You're interrupting. Why that? Why Ktoret stops the death? It says, "Vehu echad ma'ain bet shemo dubi miluo." Shh, don't talk. Miluo, mem at kroy mem 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 at kroy hey hey aleph. Open shin yud nun. So you got mem mem hey aleph shin yud nun gimatria mem 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 40 times 2 80 hey aleph 6. What you get together? 86. Shin yud nun 360. 360 plus 80. 440. 440. Wow. Plus 6? 446. Gimatria Mavet. Mem? 40. Vav? 6. Tav? 400. What did you get together? 446.
What's
Mavet? Mavet is death. What stops the Mavet, the death from the world? When a person says the Ketoret, it says the Malach HaMavet. Sam Malach HaMavet at Padarak del Moshe Rabbeinu. And he told him, when the Am Yisrael is going to do this with the secrets like that, they can stop the death from the world.
Three times a day. That's why we have that.
We читаем его три раза в день, поэтому.
Continue. Кизгулато лаацор магифа ваамави. Now, כך איך עשמים. Now, רבותיי, since you are taking the klipa away, remove the klipa for the kedusha to elevate. You're always going to do that, but backwards letters. It's called adbash. You know what adbash is? Aleph, it's code. Aleph, coded with taf. Bet, coded with shin. Gimel, coded with resh. Dalet, coded with kuf. Itagdali, all the way down. From aleph, the two extreme ones, then the one before the two, the last ones, then the one before them, and Agdali. It's called Atbash. The Torah is full of codes. It's not just a book of stories. Yaakov Takskal, Esav Takskal, that's not a book of stories. Torah is a lot of codes inside the Torah. So it says over here, this is the next code. It says, when you said the word Kahlecha, you're supposed to have in mind Yechaven, this name. This is a very powerful name that stops the Magifa. What is Magifa? Pandemic. Stops the pandemic, this name. What is that? He says, Vehu yotze michiluf chet shel kach. Vemichiluf milat lecha beayak. There's another system called ayak. What is ayak? You have the singulars, you have the tens, you have the hundreds. Right? Aleph is the first and the singular. Yud is the first in the tenth. Kuf is the first in the hundreds. So these letters, Aleph, Kuf, Yud, Aleph, they're also interchangeable. You can switch them around. So it says the Arizal, look at this carefully. If you're taking the word Kach, which is Wu Yotze Michiluf Chet, Shel Kach, flip Chet with
What is chet? Which number is chet?
Eight.
Eight. What? That's in the singular. What do you have in the tenths of eight. Of eight, which is 80? What is that? Pay. Very good. That's the pay you have here.
Ooh.
Then you have lecha. Lecha is take the system of ayak. At the system of Adbash, at the system of Ayak.
The middle.
No. The first of the
singular
tenths, 100. They are interchangeable. So take the letters Lamed. What Lamed is number?
30. 300.
So what is that? Gimel. That's the Gimel you have here. Then you have Cha. What is Cha?
20.
What? No. That's not Cha regila, a regular Chaf. That's a Chaf Sofit.
Sofit?
Different number?
Of course, it's different number. Whenever you're talking these systems, it's different number.
It's old.
Because look, you have 10 singulars.
Right.
You have 10 tens, and then you have only four hundreds.
Chaf Sofit is 500, Robert.
Where is the rest?
Okay, so
what
is the rest?
That's a Sofit. So you get from 500... till 900, yeah. Those Sofiot.
Yeah.
In order, like kaf, first one is Chaf
Sofit.
No, because if it's Chaf Sofit, it's going to be 500.
Yeah.
Mem Sofit.
And we need
Chaf Sofit.
No, I'm
saying Cha.
In the order after.
So here brings on the bottom, you see, Are she'ot Chaf mitchalefet lefet be'ot nun. Be'ot Chaf mitchalefet be'ayak be'ot he, be'ot he be'ot nun, Are she'ot Chaf mitchalefet be'ot nun. You see? He brings it from Shara Kavanot. Chaf, Sofit, interchangeable with the letter Nun. Why? Because you have
Nun is 50. Okay,
yeah.
50 and 500.
500, very good.
No, Nun Sofit is not 500.
Now pay attention, very interesting. Neria, how do you say in Hebrew the first letter in Hebrew?
Aleph.
Aleph. Put the dots differently, turn to be Aleph. Why Aleph? Because after 900, it goes back to Aleph. Then the next level becomes Aleph, number one.
Wow.
But the previous level was the last one. Ani Rishon, Ani Acharon. I'm the first one in the world, I'll be the last one in the world. That's a God representing himself in the letter Aleph. You on top, you on the bottom, and above in the middle.
How is it Ani Rishon?
I am the first one, Ani Rishon.
I'm the first and the last.
Ani Acharon, and I'm the last one in the world.
Acharon,
Pasledi. Umibal Adai and Elohim. And besides me, there's no any power in this world.
Aharon.
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 Het. Okay, next. Now, every day, Rabotai, time is limited. Every day, you're going to have another God's name in Atbash system, representing to that day. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Takdali. So he says, oh, now you'll see where the dots come from. Bayom Rishon Shel HaShavu Yechaven. If it's you're reading it on Sunday, have in mind this God's name. This is one of the names. Arizal says, whenever you eat olives, you're going to forget your Torah. You're going to forget everything. Olives causes person forgetting. When a person eats a lot of olives, yeah. Them Kubalim say, if you put 7 olives a day, you're going to cause yourself forgetfulness. However, says the Arizal, if you're going to have the right kavanot, eating olives with the proper kavanah can turn the power olive into olive oil. One of the names you're supposed to have in mind, it says, is this God's name. What is that God name? That's God name that comes from Yam. Yud is Mem. Right? If you take
Adbash.
Aleph, Bet, Gimel, Dalet, Da. Yud is the 10th letter. Start counting from the back. Taf, Shin, Resh. Which letter is going to have the 10th letter? Counting it from the back?
Mem.
So therefore, Yud of God's name, Yud Kevavke, will turn into Mem. Got it? Whenever you start reading. At this moment, you're supposed to have in mind, it says, Bayom Arishon. No. When you say, Kach Lecha, you have in mind this name, and you know where that name comes from. It's important for you to know the origin of it. Where is his passport? Where is he? Where is he from?
Adbash, right?
So he's in Ayak.
What is
his name? Shasha. Now you're directing that power to nullify the magifa, the pandemic of that day. If Chas Shalom on Sunday is supposed to be pandemic with this name that I just had in mind, and using always God's name is the fuel. God's name is always the giver. Always want to give. You're latching on it. Certain power and you push it. You have a machine. If you don't have electricity, the machine's not going to work. Right? So you can have the same thing in letters. Whenever you have a shave, at a, how you say it, haircut machine, right? You have to plug. You have a machine that cuts hair. You got to plug it into the wall. The wall is going to give you the power to operate your machine. You have a laundry machine. It's two different machines, but the electricity is the same. Same idea is over here. Whenever you have in mind God's names, all those type of names, those are powers. Those are the machines.
This is God's
how do you operate
also?
The machine? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Putting fuel in the tank. Putting fuel in the system. What is the energy that good puts that fuel? God's name. Now, since you are working in the system to break the klipa, you have to work in the system of Adbash. Adbash is always the coded way, the hidden way, the back door way. You understand? It's not straightforward. It's coming from the back door. I have no problem with that. Whenever we started Laws of Shabbat, it was also hard, but we have to grow. When a person going to the gym, a person goes to the gym to pick up weights. Pick up the weight. Oh, nimagu. Slowly, he's going to make it. The beginning is very hard. I understand. I also prepared you yesterday. I said, Rabotai, tomorrow is going to be a lot of calculations. It's not very simple day to learn this Kabbalah. But if you understand that, you bring a lot of bracha to your life. That's not a joke, this thing. I'll explain again. God's name, Yud Kev Afke, right? God's name.
Yeah.
This Yud is on the superficial way, Yud Kev Afke. Это для детям, скажи вот имя Бога. There is another name that works from the back door. Understand? It's coded. It's not open to the public. The public doesn't know about that name. What is that God's name? Yud Kev Afke. Switch it. Aleph Buzitav, Bet Buzichin, Re Gimel Buzit Reish, итак далее. Yud, God's name, Yud Ke. Yud budit mem. So you look at the over here we have God's name mem. Первый буква mem. The next, don't say that name, no. Second letter of God's name eta. What's the second letter?
Hey.
Hey, you have it on the wall right there. Yud потом какой буква идет? Hey, very good. Aleph dalet gimel dalet. Aleph bet gimel dalet. Hey. Hey, which number?
Five.
Number five. Take five letters from the back. Tav. Shin, Reish, Kuf, Tzadik. What should be Tzadik?
Tzadik
or Tzadik? Tzadik. Pranas Tzadik. Then what next letter you have? Yud Ke Vav. Pranas? Aleph, Bet, Gimel, Dalet, Hey, Vav. Vav, kakoy nomer? Six. Six.
Pay.
Tzadik. What comes before Tzadik? Tzadik is 90. What comes before 90? 80. What is 80? Pay. What should be pay? Don't make jokes. Don't make jokes. This is hard for them.
He will confuse you.
And then last letter, God's name. Last letter, hey. We already had hey. Go backwards. What is that? Tzadik. What's the ime boga? Now, how do I know which nekudot? Each letter has nekudot. It says take the word. Where is it coming from? If you're coming right now from the word kach lecha kach, what do you have under kach? Patach. Все будет патах. Все.
Первый день.
Yeah?
Sunday.
Then, леха.
The negative shachecha.
When a person have that name in mind, when he eats olives, there's one of the names. You have few names.
What's the name? Okay, I understand. But
right, because it's at the end of the word, you put tzadik sofit. Be'emet, it could be tzadik regular.
But it's a different
number.
Right.
That's whenever you are taking from there, from the text, to the letters. Как здесь, we did хав, как леха. Ха was the letter. You want to take from it to Ajax system. In Ajax system, Mansepach becomes not a hundred. This system is an Adbash system. In the Adbash system, Mansepach does not become a different, because we don't need a hundred. You understand? Now, Yom Sheni, which is Monday. What nekudo do you have of the second word of that pasuk? Kach lecha asamim nataf ushelet v'chel bena. How many words I just read? Six words. Those are going to be the nekudot of each one of the days for God's names. Except so the first word, kach, pralna. What do you have under kach? Patach. That's a God's name is going to be? Patach. Nekudot, we know it's not everything. Patach, linea.
הראשון, יום ראשון, זה נגד שכחה?
לא נגד שכחה, because this נגד, in order to have נגד שכחה,
what's the כוונה of this name?
You need to have three names there. When you eat olives, there's three names there.
If you're eating olives, okay, I understand, but I'm not eating olives.
No, then it doesn't help. That's not the name. That's the name when you eat olives, he says. El, then Elohim, then this name.
Who's eating olive oil
today? No, drink olive oil. Don't worry about it. I'm just telling you, what is that name?
What my question is a different question. If I'm reading, I'm doing Kavanah of this name.
Yeah.
What's my Kavanah?
That Kavanah is that power of this name. God's name gives fuel. That's the machine. That's the electricity.
Now,
I said it, but I'll repeat it right again. No problem.
Just that. But I'm still people talking, so...
Got it?
What's no gift?
Kick it off. No, don't say that name. This is Kabbalistic name, he says, that comes out of God's name in a system of Ayak. 1, 10, 100. 2, 20, 200. When you flip those letters around, you get this.
Over here we have three letters.
Oh, because the Kah, the Kuf, gave the Nekudot of God's name. What's going to be under the God's name, Mats, and then Pats? What Nekudot are you going to put there? Kuf. You took from the Kuf.
The Kuf. Собирали.
Understood or no?
And the Yom Sheni. What do you get from
Yom Sheni? Hold on. Now Yom Sheni, you take the second word. Kach Lecha. What do you have in Lecha? Shvana. Shvana and?
Kamatz.
Therefore, it's going to be Shvana Kamatz, Shvana Kamatz.
But then, how would you for this Yom Shabbat?
Hold on, there's next page. Hold on.
So this one, the next day, the Monday, so you're doing also Kavanah of this name and this name. So you're connecting together the machine.
Power for that name is coming from there.
Just connect this and this together.
The power for this name is coming from there. From the
next page.
This name says,
so you're stopping Magefa. You're going to a relative, Nidai Boch Baleit. He has sickness. How do you stop him from that sickness? You have to bring the machine.
So this one.
What is the machine? This God's name.
This
is the machine. Where is the plug-in? That's the name. That gives the energy.
So if I'm coming Monday, if I need to read, so I need to read this name.
Exactly. Not read. Yechavin. Everything is Kavanah. Very good. Next.
Samim.
Now we explain. Now listen to the next one. Kach lecha samim. Right? Kach lecha samim. Da. Take yourself, Hashem says, spices. Take yourself spices. Samim, на иврите spices. Это, я не знаю, на русском.
Специи.
Специи.
Кинамон.
Специи. You see, Ayin Hey? Ayin Hey means Im HaKolel. Im HaKolel. Let's make right now Gematria. Samim Bechor, Samech, 60. Mem, 40. Yud, 10. Samim Mem, 40. What you get together?
Sofit. This mem sofit is not changing.
I told you only whenever you're in the work in the system of Ayak that you need to make up. Ayak is Aleph, Yud, Kuf, which is 1, 10, 100. Now when you're going to come to 5, which is Hey, you come to 50, which is Nun. Where is the 500? There is no. Ta finishes at 400. So then you have to get into the 100, which is the Mansepach. You understand?
But Chaf Sofi is 500, no?
Huh?
Chaf Sofi.
Chaf Sofi is 500 when you work in the system of Ayak.
But we do Ayak.
Right. We did Ayak in order to take out this machine, powerful machine.
Different system. Putush system.
There's Adbar system. There's Ayak system.
Yeah.
There's Albam system.
I should call
We're going to learn it. It's not our time right now. So it says... Samim, you have to review. That's why I'm recording it for you, so you can review it after. Okay, Samim. Im HaKolel. You see, Ayin Hey? Ayin Hey stands for Im HaKolel. You should know, Gematria sometimes has included the word itself. If the word is one word, you're going to put another number. So therefore, you get the 150 in letters, right? Samich Mem, Yud Mem, получилось 150. The word itself, it's another one. You get to Kana Kuf Nun Aleph, which is 151.
The word also counts.
The word also counts. It's called Ima Kolel.
Kana
is God, one of God's name.
Also.
One of God's name, which stands for Bechor, Mikveh. When you go into the Mikveh, you're supposed to have this name in mind.
Which one?
You go to Mikveh or no, Bechor?
This is
that's the name you're supposed to have in mind. There is God's name over here. Kagda, whenever God took the Jews out of Egypt, Moshe Rabbeinu said, Moshe, Hashem, what is the name of, if they ask me your name, what should I tell them? What is the word you have here? Ekye. Just open the format. Ekye. Ekye.
151.
Yeah. When you go to the mikveh, Arizal says you're supposed to have this in mind. And that's the secret of the mikveh. What is mikveh does? Takes the impure, makes him
pure.
What is that God's name? What did Hashem did in Egypt? Took the impure Am Israel and brought them to Har Sinai. Made them
pure.
Understand? Now let's take the gematria. That's why it's important to go to mikveh. For men, for women, it's obligated. That's the Kishem. That's the name. Which is?
Exactly.
This is the name. Aleph, which is 111. Aleph, 1, 30 and 80 together, 111. Hey, hey, at the patchy patch, going to be together, 10. Yud Vav Daled, 20. Hey and hey, 10. What did you get? 10, 10 is 20. Plus 20, 40. Plus 1, 11, 151. Exactly God's name that comes out from the word Samim. Kach lecha Samim. Very good. Kaas is 150. That's the name that takes away the Kaas, Bechor. That's the name of Hashem. That's a mikveh that takes away the Kaas. The klipa of kas. What is the second kavanah you're supposed to do in the mikveh? When you go inside the water?
Kas.
I want to remove the anger. When a person is angry, he's surrounding himself with very bad energy. It's called klipat kas. He prays Hashem, give me parnasa. He prays Hashem, give me bracha. Please Hashem. Everything Hashem puts on zakriti, оболочка на него есть. Klipa называется. How do you remove this klipa? Whenever you go to the mikveh, second thing in mind, Hashem, I don't want to be angry anymore. Ever that I was angry, please remove it from me. You're removing the klipa of kas. Right, that's Ekye. That's whenever Moshe Rabbeinu asked Hashem, Hashem, give me your name. What's the name I should tell them? What God answered him? And if you open Eheye, that's the word you take out. Aleph, Eheye, right? Aleph, He, Ye. Yud, He. Got it? Now he says, with this name, what do you do? Le'alot, Tiferet, Ve'netzach, Dekol Echad Miparzufei Ak.
Is it Tiferet?
Is
it Tiferet?
Taf is Tiferet. Because it starts with Taf and finishes with Taf. Tiferet. It's in short, Taf. Ne'netzach, Dekol Echad
Miparzufei
Ak. That's a Sfira. Sfira Tiferet is Sfira Netzach. Dekol Echad Miparzufei Ak.
The sphere upon
what? Attic.
Sphere.
Right. No Adam Kadmon. Arich Anpin, which is Keter. Abba Ve'ima, which is Chochmai Bina. Zun, which is Partsuf of all the six plus the Nuk. So all the Partsufim. Attic.
The Attic Alifuf.
Attica Kadisha, it's called. Attica Kadisha.
Attic again?
Attic is the highest level of Partsufim.
It's
above Keter. Aleph, Aleph, Arich, Anpin. Arich, Aleph, Anpin.
How come Attic is not Anpin?
It's above.
Anpin?
Yeah. Anpin. Aleph, Ivav, Aleph, Eta, Abba, Ve'ima.
What's Arich?
Arich Anpin is Keter. Posle Keter, what comes out to? Chochmah, Ibina, right? Which is Abba and Ima. And then you have Zun. What is Zun? Za, Inuk. Za is the six sefirot, chesed all the way to yesod, which is brit milah. And then nuk. That's the malchut. Za, zain, achronot. Inuk, and the receiver of them.
And what is nuk
stands for? Nuk stands for malchut. Nun. Nuk. At slova nekeva. Nekeva is female. What is female? Receives the male's blessing. The male puts in her his blessing, his power.
So that's why the Yom Shlishi, the...
Right. Now, what's the Nekudot? You're going to think about God's name in Yom Shlishi, which is the third word. Which is the third word. What's the third word? Kach lecha samim. What's the Nekudot? Patach, chirik male, to budget you the Nekudot. Patach, chirik, patach, chirik.
But you have to also put this name.
Huh?
You have to put this name.
No. Right.
Would the
on the Tuesday this
not kana,
which is also corresponding to this, and with the word kana,
so not
word with the word samim, you have in mind. You, I just created right now God's name Ekiye, and with God's name Ekiye, what am I gonna do? I'm gonna pick up tiferet and netzach. All these are things in mind. It's not you picking up physically things. It's all in mind. The kol echad mi partzufei of all those partzufim. Atik ka kadisha arichan pin abba ve'im azun mikol noga de kol olam de abia. From every klipat noga of every olam of abia. Remember abia, atzilut, bria, yetzira, asiya. Nazavaitza abia.
Which line are you in?
Yeah. The third line. And have in mind, Yechaven, this is God's name.
Abia is, what
do
you say?
Atzilut, bria, Yetzirah, Asiya. And that's the name you're supposed to have in mind. V'hu yotze mechiluf, samim be'ayak. What is that? Where is that name came from? It came from word samim. 60, 40, yud, 10, mem, 40. 60? No, not in number. 60, what? What is 66, right?
6.
Which is going to be 6. What is that? Vav. What's it be vav?
Mem.
Ah, you make it smaller.
Then mem. What is mem? 40. What is 40?
4.
Or 400. This is your taf. Then you have yud. What is yud? 10. Yud is 10. And the 100 is going to be kuf. What should be kuf? And that mem sofit stays mem sofit. Mem opened. That's also one of God's names. All those names, whenever you have in mind, you're stopping the death from the world. You're stopping the sicknesses from the world. Yeah? Start Samech. Samech, 60. And the singular is going to be Vav. What was Vav? Yeah? Mem? No, it's not Adbash, it's Ayak. Mem is 40. And the 100 is going to be Taf. Here's your Taf. Yud is 10. And the 100 is going to be 100. Here's your Kuf, which is 100. And mem sofit opened into regular mem. Vehu yotze michiluf samim, vehu yotze michiluf samim be'ayak. This name of God comes out from chiluf, you're changing around with the ayak system to create this word. That name, Yechaven, this name, gimatria, mem vav, tavkuf. What is mem vav tavkuf? God's name of Ab, of mem vav, and milui ribua de kasa. Take the milui of yudke vavke in Av. Av is yudke vavke milui yudin, right? The milui of it, which is the letters inside. Yud, pishitza, yud, vav dalet. What is the milui? Vav dalet. Good. Take the milui, hey yud. What's the milui? Yud. Vav, yud, vav. Milui is yud, vav. Hey yud, milui is yud. Make gematria of this, plus the gematria of milui de ribua de kasa. Milui de ribua de kasa. What did you get? You get that name, this upper name. Now make ribua of it. Aleph is going to be Aleph. Ribua is, make it a few times. Then you have another Aleph. Then you have Yud. You see? Aleph. Aleph. Patom Yud. Patom Aleph. Patom Hey. Mixing those together, you get this. That's the sitzin we're going to come out to. Okay, now he says the combination of this is going to give you the gematria of that. And what is that? Ayak of Samim.
What's Mitkav?
That's names of Hashem that you're able to stop sickness from the world. If you would know these secrets before, you will go to all the hospitals, you'll go to all the sick people and you heal them. No joke.
Heal them?
Heal them.
So, how do you get this name again?
It depends if the evil glitches on them again or not. It depends how dirty that person is.
When you're saying Samim,
that Kavanah removes the evil from there. The evil said, I cannot go whenever you have the Kavanot next to that. Of the Ktovet next to that person.
All this Firot is bringing to you the
loss of the person, yeah. In Eretz Israel, Rabbi Kaduri, whenever there was a war, Tell gave them those pamphlets, said, have this in mind to stop the war with Iran 20 years ago. Iran, whatever you call them. They sent so many missiles, they didn't kill any person 20 years ago. How could it be stopping the death like that? The zechut of the Ktoret with the Kavanah. Baruch, Be'ezat Hashem, next time we'll continue again. Baruch Adonai Le'olam, Amen v'Amen.